Hi, it's Alan from Crashtest Security. In this video, I will tell you more about broken access control vulnerabilities. Let's get started. Broken access control vulnerabilities are common in modern applications since the design and implementation of access control mechanisms rely on a highly complex ecosystem of multiple components and processes. In such a complex, changing ecosystem, security teams should apply several legal, organizational, and business logic to ensure the tech stack is watertight and has no room for hackers to exploit the system. As it sounds, the job isn't easy, and there are fair chances of unknown vulnerabilities on account of a formal approach to tackling security. The traditional method of identifying access-related vulnerabilities is to rely on manual testing. Due to the lack of automated continuous detection, access control vulnerabilities often remain unnoticed and are potentially targeted by hackers at a much higher intensity. Broken access control features in the OWASP top 10 vulnerabilities, since hackers can exploit these to masquerade as users and access resources using privileged functions. Most access control schemes are not deliberately designed using a guided framework. Instead, they evolve with the web application's use. Besides this, a flawed access scheme is relatively easy to identify and exploit. In most cases, the hacker has to create a request for consent or functions they aren't permitted to access. Once the flaw has been detected, the impacts can range from mild to severe, depending on the content's sensitivity and protection controls. Almost every web server and application deployment is susceptible to at least one broken access control vulnerability. Depending on which resources the attackers get the permission to access, the impacts of a successful attack could be detrimental. Some business impacts of access control failures include exposure of unauthorized content. Once an attacker has gained unauthorized access privileges, they typically crawl the site for information on gaining more permissions. While doing so, they access sensitive system and user data, which they can obtain from the black market or other malicious acts. With a successful attack, the hacker can view, modify, or even delete the sensitive data, hindering system performance, the company's reputation, and availability. Privilege escalation. Hackers exploit access flaws, mainly to gain privileged access to resources and services, typically protected from normal users and applications. Most commonly, hackers initially intend to take control of as many user accounts as possible. With an elevation of privilege, hackers can easily steal user data or deploy malicious payloads that can damage the entire application hosting ecosystem. Distributed denial of service. With access to numerous user accounts, attackers can deploy bots on these accounts and use them to cause the system to crash by sending numerous requests at a go. Additionally, they deploy malicious payloads that render the application inaccessible and unavailable for authorized users and services. Broken authentication vulnerabilities can be categorized as vertical, horizontal, and context-dependent privilege escalation. Vertical privilege escalation. Vertical access controls are used to restrict access to crucial functions not available to other users in the organization. For example, broken vertical access controls can be explored to access functions that ordinary users can't access, such as modifying and deleting user accounts. Examples of vertical privilege escalation attacks from broken vertical access controls include unprotected sensitive functionality, parameter-based attacks, and broken access control due to platform misconfiguration. Horizontal privilege escalation. Horizontal access controls enable different application users to access similar resource types. These mechanisms restrict access to the resources only to the group of users allowed to access the resource. For instance, a banking application lets clients view their transactions records, but not of other users. Broken horizontal access controls enable attackers to access resources belonging to other users and are caused by improper ID controls. Context-dependent privilege escalation. Often, attackers compromise privileged users to turn horizontal privilege escalation attacks into vertical privilege escalation. For instance, hackers may use broken horizontal controls to retrieve another user's login credentials. The attackers can then target administrative accounts, which gives them administrative rights to escalate privileges vertically. Some context-dependent privilege escalation attacks include insecure direct object reference, multi-step attacks, attacks on referrer-based mechanisms, and attacks on geographical location-based mechanisms. Try Crashtest Security today to discover how it integrates into your development stack for efficient, automated vulnerability scanning. The trial is free. Also, Subscribe to the Crashtest Security Channel to get more information about the most significant web security threats, their prevention, and how to use the Crashtest Security Suite. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.